The other thing that makes men lose their ordination is carnal and wayward living. A lot of people do not understand that it's dangerous for them to live a carnal life. A lot of pastors today are living immorality. Why? They believe that God can forgive them. It's true that God can forgive you, but it will not take too long. You will lose the carnal lifestyle of your ordination. It will not take too long that you lose something. When Samson lost something, he knew he lost something. The strength that God gave was upon him, a kind of feeling of the Nazarene. And as long as he did not abide by the kind of nature of the Nazarene, the problem came up. Every spiritual man lives by a kind of concentration. When you don't abide by the concentration, there is going to be a challenge. Whether you like it or not, God will come up with a certain level of concentration on you. And that level of concentration will demand that you should not live a life that is way more up to darkness. A lot of times you think that it does not matter. It matters, my friend. The lifestyle you are living in carnal nature matters so much. God do not want you to live a life of waywardness. No. Many people are anointed, but they still love women. Other people are anointed, but they still love alcohol. They let you know why they still love literature. They love to still drink beer. They prophesy, they speak in tongues, but they go back and they relax with the beer. They prophesy, they do one thing, but then they come back and they begin to masturbate. They return back and begin to watch pornography. Not as though it's something that they know that they are praying for God to help them. No, it's their normal lifestyle. When you talk to them, you see that it's not from them. That God will not count that unto them. When a man lives in carnal and a wayward life, the ordination of God upon his life will be hidden away. You will lose a lot of things. Your own will not be a coat of many colors, but your own will be an ordination in God and a partition in God. Amen. One of the greatest reasons why people partition them is sucked away is what I call the danger of immorality. Bible speaking in the book of Proverbs 6:26. He said, by the way of a warrior's woman, by the way of an adulterous woman, the man is reduced to a piece of hair. Whether you like it or not, wayward living has killed many anointed men. By the way of an adulterous woman, the strength of many great men we have reduced. Many men that were valiant for God, their life was reduced to nothing because of the way of an adulterous woman. Whether you like it or not, when you live a wayward life for a long time, the spirit of a woman that you associate yourself with, she will turn you back to her own kind of style. Change the fortune of every great man, it was traceable to a woman. Somehow, one day he met a woman and continued to sleep with her, and suddenly the strength in God went away. Occulting people sleep with ladies so that they can take away the virtue of ladies for them to function. But when a spiritual man begins to do that, his life is reduced to nothing. God himself is the one that will reduce his strength upon you. By doing the microphone for you, God will be the one that will reduce your strength to nothing. Because you know that if you leave you in that your darkness, you are going to cause more havoc to the kingdom of light. Many men of God are so anointed, but they have to sleep with every lady in the church. They don't know it's a curse. Say, is there not a curse? When you live a real-world life, I assure you that you do not think that God will take away his candle lamps and upon you. Somehow, God, if God will not keep you by his mercy, he will ensure that your relevance is reduced. That is the reason why many great men become nothing. The ordination upon them is taken away. They live a secret life of waywardness. Today they are in Amina place. Next tomorrow they are in Jumoke place. Next tomorrow they are in Blessing place. Next tomorrow they are... You see a very anointed lady, but she sleep around everywhere. After she finished ministry for choir, she moved to a guy's house and she sleep around again. A very anointed guy, but he doesn't know why he always finds himself in the beer panel. He does not know why he loves to sleep. He does not know why he loves to do all kinds of things. When you live a wayward life for a very long time, God himself, if God does not take away the ointment upon your head, he will reduce you to nothing so that his kingdom can advance. You must be careful of wayward living. Anytime you are praying and you are fasting and you are loving God, and there is a certain level of carnality in you, Paul cry out. He said, who will deliver me from this bondage of corruption? God was the one that cried and said, oh God, I have an infirmity in my flesh. He said, there are things I do not want to do, I find myself doing, but there are things I'm supposed to do, I find myself doing. He said, who will deliver me from this bondage of corruption? Paul cried out, don't be comfortable in that your darkness. It has the ability to reduce you to nothing. Being anointed is very easy. Maintaining the anointing is very hard. As a man begins to rise in this pinnacle of greatness, the time comes that it's very cheap for you to be anointed. But the anointing causes a lot of attraction. The anointing attracts good, it attracts bad. All kinds of things come to you. God has not dealt with you, you will fall and will want you. Another thing that takes away the ordination of men is lack of consistency. Many believers begin praying, You see, a man said, anytime you see somebody that will not allow you to sleep, every day you come to his house. Every night you wake up at night, you bring the supper, you say, give him time. But you give them all the time, after 2 weeks, 3 weeks, you discover that time will come, they will not be consistent. They will know that you and I cannot be consistent. Consistency is not in the nature of mankind. So when you see a man that is consistent, you know his spirit is involved. Anytime a man is consistent, you know his spirit is involved. Somehow, there's a spirit that is energizing to remain consistent for this long time. Because according to the nature of mankind, man should not be doing one thing for very long time, he should pass life from it. So when you see a man doing a thing again and again, the spirit is ensuring that that thing will succeed. Many believers, their ordination, their calling is taken away because they are not consistent with God. You begin on fire for God. Bah, 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 bah. Everybody knew you on fire. In the area, everybody knew you are a woman that can play. After 1 year, you don't have 50 boyfriends. One, you're not consistent. Somehow, you didn't give me because you say you're tired. Somebody met me, she said, can we go? That's the first time I hear somebody say that. Can we remove the Holy Spirit from her? That we should unfill her with the Holy Spirit. This was a lady who filled her with the Holy Ghost. And she was praying fervently. One day she came and said she don't understand that the body connects with Christ in her life. That can we unfill her with the Holy Spirit? That maybe part of it, she was a carnal believer. Eh? That she will not be experiencing the attack she's experiencing. I don't know whether you have many people like that. They take the money, pray the money, receive attack. So they want to stop praying. I said, you don't understand that the reason why you are receiving attack when you are praying is because you are breaking through the corridors and the shackles of darkness over your family. Because when the man begins to pray, the first thing that is switched on is a realm called spiritual warfare. Because the demonic spirits that are attached to your life to ensure that your life does not advance. When you begin to pray, it's as if you're trying to gain energy to ascend beyond them. So there will be all kinds of warfare. And when you stop praying, they will surmount you. I told her that the solution to our life is for her to pray more. She said, no, I'm filled with the Holy Spirit. It's lack of consistency. Many believers are on fire for God. But after 2 years, 3 years, they are passing them. Why? Because they lack consistency. When a man lacks consistency, the ordination upon his head will be taken away. Let me tell you, no man you see today that is relevant in God beginning 2 years, beginning 3 years in life. Another believer that is relevant in God has been in God for the past 5 years, 7 years, 8 years, 10 years. You must be consistent in God. This prayer I did, continue to pray it again and again and again and again. The story will continue. One day, the light of God will shine upon your path. And God will reveal himself in a greater measure. He will put something upon your lips, put something upon your hand, do something to your head, do something to your heart, and the world will not reject. But by the time you are not consistent, the ordination, the power, and everything you think you have in God will be sampled with you. Another thing that ensures that men are not consistent, that the ordination of men is taken away, is what I call spiritual warfare. It is true that we rise by warfare in this kingdom, but a lot of times many people are swallowed by spiritual warfare. Many people, when the warfare begin to come over their life, they give up in Christianity. I don't know why many people give up in spiritual warfare, but they feel that the calling is too much upon them. Many people are the casualty of warfare, they die of warfare. I told you that spiritual warfare are fought on legal grounds, and only them that understand the legalities always win the warfare. Many people do not understand the legality of spiritual warfare. So they engage spiritual warfare as spiritualists. So they die eventually. They must understand that as you join Christianity, the devil is going to come to always attack you as a believer. When he comes to attack you, if you cannot survive very well, you will die. And that may be the reason why the ordination of God upon your head will be taken away. Somehow, many people, when they collided with a being that is bigger than death in warfare, they die just like that. You must understand that there is a spirit that wants to make you live forever. There is a spirit that wants to kill you. There is a spirit that do not want you to rise alive. That spirit, the Bible says, this is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, power, thrones, and dominion. Whether you like it or not, there are powers of darkness seeking to ensure that we remain within the level. We must wrestle against them. Yes, sir. We rise by warfare. The more we conquer, the more they give us a ramp to the spirit. It's like a general in the army. Every general, there is no man that becomes a general without fighting war. If you are afraid of war, then ensure that you remain without being promoted to the army. Another thing that swallows the ordination of men is what I call lack of self-control. Many believers are very spiritual, but they lack self-control. Self-control is one of the greatest fruit of the spirit a believer can ever have. When a man has self-control, it's to put himself under control. It's to be able to tell no to himself. Anytime the power of darkness comes over you, sometimes you can just say no to yourself, apply your will against it, and you can survive. The ability for you to control yourself. Everybody has a level of darkness in him, but we do not need with expression. The Bible says the darkness in you become great, become light. How great will the darkness be? Somehow, if the darkness in you is the light that you reveal, how great would it be? Let me tell you, the flesh can do many signs and wonders. I don't know about you. It's not only the spirit that does signs and wonders, the flesh too does signs and wonders. Having to do something sometimes you wonder, is it me that did this thing? No, it was your flesh. Why? Because your ability to control yourself, give your flesh expression. And if that darkness in you become like your light, it will become great. I need to understand that no matter how bright you are, there are some level of darkness God is still trying to deal with. That is why you get a closure of mortality. If you are not careful with that area of darkness, it will take away the ordination of God upon your life. So you must be careful enough as a believer to apply self-control in everything you do. Anytime you find yourself in a situation, should I sleep the phone? No, control yourself. Say, I will not. Should I masturbate? No, I will not. Should I have sex with a guy? No, I will not. Your ability to say no, your ability to be able to control yourself, bring yourself under order, the self-control. By the help of the Spirit of God, God can give you the grace and the strength to say no. Bible says the grace of God that brings salvation to us has appeared to all men, teaching us to say no to ungodliness. That it is possible for a believer to say no. Should we go and rob the bank? Say no. Can you drink alcohol? Say no. Your ability to control yourself is very important as a believer. Another thing that can take away the ordination of men upon their life is lack of spiritual intelligence. Many people are so ignorant. Your area of ignorance is your area of darkness. Your area of darkness is the area you never capitalize upon to deal with you. Bible speaking says, because you have rejected knowledge, I have rejected you. Somehow, people that will do more than you, this people that either know more than you or pray more than you. You can decide to pray, you want to pray. Many believers don't know anything. They don't even know what is righteousness. They don't know what is salvation. They don't even know what is godliness. They don't pay the price to learn. How can you have intelligence for the many believers, they may be prophetic in nature, but they are like herbalists. Why? Because they don't understand prophetic intelligence. They behave like spiritualists because they don't have the structure of the word of God. It is not good for your soul to be without knowledge. Lack of spiritual knowledge, that will make you not have spiritual authority. Spiritual authority comes by obedience to spiritual knowledge. When a man is obedient to the knowledge of the kingdom, the Lord added unto him authority. When a man abides in spiritual understanding, come to a point of spiritual understanding, you come into the realm of authority. There's a level of intelligence you need to have as a believer. You need to be superior. For you to rule and reign upon the face of the earth. Lack of that understanding will make the devil capitalize upon it to steal your ordination. The reason why many people cannot rule spiritually is because of lack of that intelligence. Another thing that will ensure that certain men can never grow in the impartation is what I call laziness. Lack of self-discipline. Many believers are so lazy. They cannot pay the price to learn. They can't even listen to messages. They can't even pray. They cannot even fast. How do you want to know which people that you want to happen in your life? You must pay the price to grow. You must pay the price to learn. There is no that discipline upon them to stay and learn. Come to church, they cannot even come. Come for prayer meeting, they cannot even come. Listen to message, they cannot. Read your Bible, they cannot. Fast, they cannot. There is nothing they say they should do, they can do with you. Let me tell you. Whether you like it or not, the anointing of God will take away your laziness. Success is inversely proportional to laziness. No man that is successful in God is a lazy man, is a liar. You must be a man that works hard. Speak to say I labor more than they all. Whether you like it, there's a place for labor. You must labor in the kingdom, you must study more, you must pray more, you must fast more, you must give more, you must do all of those things alone. You cannot be a man and a woman without self-discipline. To discipline yourself to do the things of the kingdom. You cannot be a woman that is lazy. Wake up at night to pray and say, no, you are lazy, you want to sleep. How do you want the ordination upon you to remain? No, devil will take it away. You must ensure that your life is not the government of God and you abide by God.